Haram demand 30 million ransom, 30 million naira ransom for Adama victims in captivity. The chairman of the council, James Pukuma, said on Monday during the visit of the Speaker of the Adamawa State House of Assembly that the death toll from the attacks had risen from 7 to 10 following the discovery of 3 more corpses. The death toll from Boko Haram attacks on Kwanpe community, Hong local government area, Adamawa State has risen to 10. This is just as some members of the community said on Monday that they got a call on Sunday from members of Boko Haram demanding the 30 million naira to be paid for the release of 30 persons abducted during the attacks by insurgents on the community, Punch reports. The chairman of the council, James Pukuma, said on Monday during the visit of the Speaker of the Adamawa State House of Assembly that the death toll from the attacks had risen from 7 to 10 following the discovery of 3 more corpses. The attack on Kwanpe was said to have been carried out by Boko Haram terrorists who killed 7 persons and displaced over 5,000 persons. Meanwhile, 2 residents of Kwanpe who spoke on condition of anonymity said that the attackers called on Sunday to demand 30 million naira ransom. But the council chairman denied knowledge of any ransom demand. He said there is no talk of any ransom or demand for it. As of yesterday, there were 7 deaths, but today it has risen to 10, while 53 persons who are hospitalized are being treated. Well, today's news, the Boko Haram activities has not started today. They have been here with us, even from the General Olusegun Obasanjo administration, but their operation is not as high as this. What I'm trying to inculcate into the heart of the government is that all the general public, this Boko Haram activities does not start today. I'm not only blame Buhari for Boko Haram system. What we are blaming him is that it has now gained ground everywhere and the government has not done anything to flush them out. Like Major General Olusegun Obasanjo, the former head of state, and Goodluck Jonathan, at that time they will try their best to make sure that these people will not operate again. But it's like in this new administration, they encourage them to continue to harass and kill people, especially the state of Borno State. So, ladies and gentlemen, in the state or in the country where the government have no capacity to lead, what do you expect? Miscreants, strangers can begin to find their way into the country and commit one havoc or the other and go away. Like this BH people. Now, they have abducted some persons from Borno State and they are demanding 30 million naira ransom. And somebody who is in charge of the case is denying that he has not heard anything like that. Now, this demanding shows that these people, they are on top of the whole system and they believe that nobody can chase them out. You see, It's like a man seated in his compound, and some persons just come and raid him out and occupy the place. So, ladies and gentlemen, let us all rise and begin to talk sense into the heart of Nigerians so that all this nonsense will stop. I'm not saying that the Nigerian government does not know what they are doing. They know what they are doing. But it's just that the government is not positive. The government is not a responsible one, because we have not seen their impact in the life of the citizen. For decades, years, Boko Haram has been operating. How can you tell me that an independent country does not have soldiers and equipment enough to chase these people out? Now, years ago, it was even alleged that the present government are the sponsor of the Boko Haram, the gunmen, the Fulani herdsmen, and what have you. So, if sometime you will look at it from an angle that it is true, because we have not heard the voice of the government in connection to the activities of Boko Haram. Right now, they have carried away some persons captive, and they are demanding 30 million naira. You see, that is a very big problem, which means if their relatives or the government does not pay them that ransom, they will waste the people's life. So is it the country that, you see what you are talking about in this country? So I would like here to educate the government that in future, if the government refuses to do anything to these people that are terrorizing our communities every day, in future, they will get hold of them and raid them too. The fact that they are destroying the common man's life does not mean they will not go to them, to theirs in time to come. Because if they continue to waste life, and they have not seen anybody to waste his life again, they will waste the life of the people on top. So, I want to say here that government has the capacity to stop the activities of Boko Haram. It is a bias. They are just doing by cutting. They know what they are doing. They are the supplier. They supply weapons to these people. They give them food. They give them everything they need. In fact, it is alleged that the government is responsible for their activities. Thank you.